This video is about respiratory diseases. Chronic respiratory diseases like asthma and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease are usually characterized by inflammation of the airways, airflow obstruction, the incomplete function of the lungs, along with a high degree of associated morbidity and mortality chances. Although the ideal treatment for such long-term respiratory diseases is the use of medications like beta blockers, which allow the person to breathe better immediately, it is not limited to pharmacological management only. As the treatment options are advancing and new studies are being conducted, the effect of change of diet on the management of these respiratory diseases can be seen, allowing certain foods to be used as a possible adjuvant therapy, along with the essential medications. What is asthma? Asthma is a chronic condition of the lungs that is associated with narrow and inflamed airways, difficult for the person to breathe. It can be stimulated by several factors like dust pollution, allergens, exercise, tobacco smoke, GERD, and even certain emotions like anxiety and stress. Asthma is usually associated with acute asthma attacks, where a person feels like they cannot breathe and require immediate medical help. This help can either be provided in a hospital setting if the asthma is uncontrolled, or can be given at home by the use of prescribed inhalers. However, other than the pharmacological interventions, certain foods can help manage the symptoms of asthma in the long term. Foods that can help prevent asthma attacks. Since asthma is primarily an inflammatory condition, foods that have inherent anti-inflammatory properties should be consumed on an everyday basis for the prevention of asthma attacks and the management of symptoms in the long run. These foods include fruits and vegetables, as they are packed with antioxidants, fibers, vitamins, and minerals, which are beneficial for health. Foods THT can manage asthma. Bananas. Bananas can be used as a medicinal food source for asthmatics due to its rich supply of potassium and magnesium. Studies have shown that these two nutrients are very important for those suffering from frequent asthma attacks, as the lack of these can potentially affect lung functions, as seen in children in the age group of 11 to 19 years. This effect can be explained by the fact that magnesium is a mineral essential for the maintenance of electric potential across cell membranes. Hence, it plays a major role in the relaxation and constriction of smooth muscles. When magnesium is abundant in the body, the smooth muscles are relaxed, allowing better airways transmission. Since asthma is associated with the constriction of airways, magnesium may help keep these muscles relaxed in the long term. Since the levels of magnesium are mediated by potassium level changes in intracellular and serum levels, low levels of this will also indirectly affect the smooth muscles of the airways. Liver and fish oil. Liver and fish oil, being one of the highest sources of vitamin A, regular controlled consumption of these along with other vitamin A rich foods can be used for the effective treatment and prevention of asthma attacks. These respiratory health promoting properties of asthma can be seen in a study conducted on 117 children with asthma who were divided into three groups according to the severity of their asthma symptoms, after which their serum vitamin A levels along with pulmonary tests were conducted. The results of the study showed that the asthma severity was positively interrelated with the vitamin A levels, which proved that those children who had higher vitamin A levels had better lung functionality than those who have comparatively lower levels. What is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD? COPD is a long-term condition affecting the lungs and is composed of two conditions, one emphysema and two chronic bronchitis. At one end, chronic bronchitis is an inflammation of the bronchial tube linings and causes wet cough. Emphysema is associated with damaged alveoli, which are small structures for gas exchange at the end of the respiratory passage inside the lungs. COPD is one of the leading causes of death all over the world. due to its ability to greatly affect the overall health of a person. What makes it dangerous is that the symptoms only worsen over time, and if not treated at the right time, can lead to a person becoming completely debilitated and unable to carry out the normal activities. Diet for COPD. The treatment goal for the patients of COPD is to reduce the level of their malnutrition to allow them to be healthy enough to fight off diseases. But at the same time, it should be made sure that their respiratory quotient and carbondioxide production is not increased. Keto diet. A keto diet is a form of diet that contains very high fats levels and none to minimum carbohydrate levels. To allow the average metabolism of the body to shift from carbohydrates to fats. Although this diet is used for its numerous beneficial properties, studies have shown that this high-fat, low-carb diet may also be used for patients suffering from chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. For example, in a study conducted on 60 COPD patients, the effects of this diet were evaluated against the improvement in the symptoms associated with the disease. The results showed that those participants who were given a high-fat, low-carb diet as a part of their evening meals had significantly improved lung function as compared to those who were not given. Moreover, another study showed a significant decrease in the carbon dioxide production and carbon dioxide end-tidal partial pressure in those participants of the study who were put on a ketogenic diet for 2 months as compared to the compared Mediterranean diet. This change is theorized to be due to the ability of the ketogenic diet to get rid of excess carbon dioxide stores in the body, which have been collected due to the inability of the lungs to function properly in COPD patients. Conclusion. Long-term respiratory diseases are usually associated with prolonged inflammation, affecting the respiratory pathways. Hence, it is recommended to consume foods that promote anti-inflammatory and antioxidants activities in the body. Note: this information is for reference only. It is not meant to replace the need to seek the attention of a competent medical professional. Do not engage in the practice of self-help when it comes to the diagnosis and treatment of serious medical conditions. Always seek the attention of a qualified medical professional to get the best health care for yourself and your family. Here ends this video presentation. We hope you enjoyed the video. Like the video. Share the video. And subscribe. To receive alerts when we produce these types of videos in the future. Subscription is totally free. Thanks for watching. See you again soon.